الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wa sallam has said that a person who sends 50 times daily durood or salutations or salawat upon me, I will shake hands with him on the day of judgment. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Salatan wa salaman alayka ya sayyidi ya rasulallah wa ala alika wa ashabika ya habiballah. Dearest Islamic brothers and the viewers of Madani channel, Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, once again we are blessed with the opportunity to participate in this blessed silsila, blessings of hadith of Madani channel. As usual, inshallah Azza wa Jal, we will recite and discuss and try to understand few ahadith of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This hadith is reported from Hazrat Irbaz bin Sariyah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He says, one day Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam led us in salat, and then he turned his blessed face towards us, and he delivered a very touching and inspiring bayan, a lecture. Eyes were shedding tears, hearts were scared. A man asked, Ya Rasulullah, maybe this is the last nasiha that you are giving to us. So please give us nasiha. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa sallam replied, he said, I advise you or I give you nasiha about taqwa, about the fear of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal, and to listen and obey the ruler, even if he is a black slave. Because those who would be living after me, they will see huge conflict, ikhtilaf. Therefore, you should hold fast my sunnat and the sunnat of my guided khulafa, Khulafa-i Rashideen. And hold it tight with your teeth. Refrain from new things. Every new thing is an innovation, and every innovation is misguidance. This was the translation of Hadith Mubarakah. In this hadith, a special lecture, a special talk, a special discourse of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned. All the speeches, all the discourses of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam were always inspiring and touching the hearts, bringing change into people. But this was a very special lecture, because in this lecture, the ishq, the love of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal was discussed, and the fear of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal was also discussed. And the environment became very emotional, that people started weeping, they started crying, their eyes were shedding tears, and their hearts were shivering with the fear of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal. Now, one man stood up and he said, Ya Rasulullah, maybe this is the last advice you are giving. Why he said that? He said that because he took a guess that normally when someone is leaving this world, he talks this type of things, he gives this type of nasiha and wa'az. So he felt that maybe Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is about to leave the ummah, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is giving the last nasiha, the last word of advice. This was the intelligence, the sharpness of the mind of Sahaba Ikram, that they could assess the situation. And it was, in reality, close to the time of the departure of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam from this domain. Otherwise, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would have refuted that, no, this is not the case. What you are saying, this is not the case. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not refute. This tells us that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam confirmed his fear. That as you are thinking that I'm about to depart from this world, that is true. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam indeed knew the time of his departure from this world. And then the nasiha, the advice which is given, is jami', is very collecting. It collects ahkam, the orders, the rules of Sharia. And there are two things mentioned. One is taqwa, and the other thing is mentioned about following the Amir, following your ruler. So when you talk about taqwa, then all the dini ahkam are covered. All the dini rulings are covered. And when you talk about following the sultan, following the Muslim ruler, then all your political issues are covered. So everything, every issue that you have to face is contained in two words of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam motivated Sahaba Ikram, and this lesson is for all the Muslims, not just for Sahaba Ikram, by giving an example. In Arabia those days, people would get slaves from African countries, mainly from Abyssinia, who was known as Habsha. So most of the black slaves in those days were called Habshi. So therefore, their example has been given. As Habshi slave. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that follow your Amir, follow your leader, even if he is Habshi ghulam, Habshi slave. So it means that don't look at his looks, don't look at his color, don't look at his face, don't look at his family background. As long as he has been given that responsibility to lead you, to rule your affairs and enforce the laws of Sharia, then you have to follow him. You don't have a choice. You cannot say no, you know, change this person and bring another person and then I will follow. Any person, white or black, Arab or non-Arab, as long as he has been put on that position, we have to follow him. And keep in mind that Khilafat is exclusive with Quraysh. The Quraysh tribe, the tribe of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Khilafat is exclusive with that tribe. Person must be Qurayshi in order to be a Khalifa. But Amarat, to be Amir, to be ruler, to be Sultan, any Muslim can take that position. Any Muslim can become Amir, can become Hakim, can become Sultan and enforce the laws of Sharia. So therefore this hadith is not against the hadith in which it is said Al-Khilafatu lil-Quraishi. Khilafat is for Quraysh. So this hadith is not against that hadith, because here we're talking about Amarat, we're talking about being Sultan, and that is allowed for a non-Qurayshi to hold that position. And also, when we talk about following the Amir, it means that follow the Amir in Ahkam Sharia. If he orders the Ahkam, the rules of Sharia, then we will follow him. But if he orders something contrary to the laws of Sharia, then we will not follow him. And this emphasis which has been put here in this Hadith Mubarakah to follow the Amir is about Amir, mean who has been appointed as Amir, who has been appointed as Hakim. Not the person who by force takes it over and he is incapable of doing that job and fulfilling that responsibility. For example, in the issue of Yazid. So Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala did not accept him as Hakim. Therefore his standing up against Yazid is not contrary to this Hadith Mubarak. One cannot say that, oh, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that you should follow your Amir even if he is black slave. But Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala did not follow Yazid. So the fact of the matter is that Yazid was not appointed as Hakim. He was not appointed. He disqualified for that position because of his wrongdoings. And his wrongdoings were too many. So therefore, one cannot blame Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu based on this Hadith Mubarakah. And then in this Hadith Mubarakah, it is said that those who would live after me, they'll see ikhtilaf, they will see conflicts, fights. So those conflicts would be of two types, political conflicts and religious conflicts as well. which we have seen many and we are still seeing. Religious conflicts, when people create new sects, they manufacture new beliefs which are not in Islam. And based on new beliefs, they form a group. And then the conflict starts. And then the debates with each other, picking on each other, you know, all those type of issues will start, and conflict and the unity breaks. And at that time, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised us what to do. That when you see those conflict, hold tight my sunnah and the sunnah of my Khulafa'i Rashideen al-Mahdiyeen, the guided one. And of course, Khulafa'i Rashideen are the guided ones. So that would help you to get out of that difficult situation. Because when there's a conflict, you might be confused and you want to know which side should I be. So at that time, you should see what is the sunnah of my beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is the sunnah of Khulafa Rashideen? So I'll follow that path. I'll have those beliefs. I will not adopt new beliefs. It doesn't matter how much sense those things make, because people can put intellectual arguments and tricks and make a lot of sense out of things which are untrue, and many people then can believe those things. So now we have a criteria. The criteria is that don't trust your intellect even at that time, because it can mislead you. So trust the way of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Trust the way of those who are trained by our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Therefore, their way is also called sunnah, as it is mentioned in this hadith mubarakah: عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين. My sunnat and the sunnat of my Khulafa Rashidin. Normally, the word sunnat is used for the saying and for the doings and ahwal, the conditions, the states of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But in lughvi meaning, in its literal meaning, the afaal and the amal, doing and the sayings of Sahaba Ikram Ridwanullah ta'ala alayhi majma'een, is also called sunnat. And then in this hadith mubarakah, it is said that refrain from new things, because every new thing is bid'ah and every bid'ah is misguidance. So what is meant by it? What are those new things which are being talked here in this hadith mubarakah? Every new thing means here a new aqeedah which has been made or created in Islam after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is what is being condemned. And that's what is called gumarahi, misguidance. Because gumarahi is in aqeedah, not in action. So therefore, when it is said, every bid'ah is misguidance, that means this relates to aqeedah, not to action. So the meaning of hadith mubarakah is that anyone who makes a new aqeedah in Islam, that is rejected, that is condemned, and that is misguidance. So some people try to implement this hadith on Milad celebration, on Urus, on Fatiha. That's not correct. Because what is being condemned and refuted here are the new aqaid, the beliefs which people make, they manufacture, and they try to introduce as Islamic beliefs. وعن عبد الله بن مسعود قال خط لنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خطا ثم قال هذا سبيل الله ثم خط خطوطا عن يمينه وعن شماله وقال هذه سبل على كل سبيل منها شيطان يدعو إليه وقرأ أن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه الآية رواه أحمد والنسائي والدارمي. This hadith mubarakah has been reported by Hazrat Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala that our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he drew a line and he said, this is the path of Allah. And then he drew few lines from the right side of that line and from the left side of that line. Couple of lines, this way and that way. And then he said, these are different paths. This way, that way, from right, from left, these are different paths. And at the end of every path, Shaitan is standing and he's inviting. He's calling towards himself. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited this ayah kareema, أَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ. This hadith has been reported by Imam Ahmad, Imam Nisai and Imam Darami. Subhanallah, what a beautiful education that has been given to Muslims in Quran Kareem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls the path of Islam as Sirat-e-Mustaqim. And the meaning of Sirat-e-Mustaqim is straight path. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam practically showed the Sahaba Ikram by drawing a straight line. He said, this is the path of Allah. This is the path that will take you to success. This is the path that will earn you salvation on the day of judgment. And straight path is very simple, straightforward, very easy, no complications. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam drew several other lines and he said that all these lines are crooked, they're not straight. So when a line is crooked, when the path is crooked, then of course you will not reach your destination. At the end, you will be a loser. And Shaitan stands at the end of every path. When we talk about Sabilullah, the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, what it means that true aqaid, correct aqaid, and good deeds. If a person, he holds correct aqaid, correct beliefs, beliefs which are understood by the teachings of mainstream Muslims, and together with that, good deeds. That is the straight path. And that is the path which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam drew and showed Sahaba Ikram that this is the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also keep in mind that four paths of Shariat and four paths of Tariqat. Hanafi, Maliki, Shafi, Hanbali, Chishti, Qadri, Sohrawardi, Naqshbandi. These are not different paths. They all are Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. They belong to one path. Because path changes because of difference in Aqidah, not because of minor difference in practice. Ameen bi jahin nabiyil ameen sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salatun wa salamun alayka ya sayyidi ya rasulallah wa ala alika wa ashabika ya habiballah.